really hard to concentrate when the cutest little girl on the planet is sitting right here. Like, she's so darling.
Can you say hello to everybody?
And then
say
Kendall's
hi.
Here, too.
All right. Kendall's here. So, oh boy.
Or oh girl.
It's almost time to find out the sex of my baby from Dr. Oz. How cool is that? Okay, it's something even I don't know. Seriously, Hal and I don't know. We were just at the doctor. But before we do that, our Kenny Crumpton had a very important mission. So take a look.
I think I got what I needed to. Come on in.
Okay, Lisa, how are you?
I'm good.
Kenny Crumpton,
nice to meet you.
I got to handle some business. Okay, you two, out of here. Let's go.
See you guys.
Got to talk to the doc here. All right. Let me see. Okay, Doc. Now, so you did all the sonogramming and stuff you need to do, right?
Yes, I did.
So now we know what sex or what gender.
We do.
Okay, so can you type up on the back computer here and get us a little envelope that'll tell us what gender?
Absolutely.
Because I don't know what I'm looking at, so why don't you do your little magic here?
Absolutely.
Okay, all right, aha, here it is. All right, Christy's baby gender reveal. Hermetically sealed.
Medically sealed.
One knows.
Nobody knows.
I have everything I need in this envelope, right, Lisa?
Yes, you do.
Okay, now I have to go right now.
Yes.
Okay. There's not a second to spare.
Resuscitated. Yeah.
That was so funny. I'm sorry, hospital, they were so generous to us. We caused a circus yesterday, didn't we?
I think he just kept going right to the ER to get that hamstring looked at.
Right? Oh, Kenny, that was adorable. So the good news is that envelope that Kenny had made it all the way to New York City.
And now it is in the hands of the one and only Dr.
Oz. Yeah, Hal and Kendall are here with me, anxiously awaiting the big news. You guys excited?
Yes.
Yes.
Dr. Oz is right there joining us.
Hi, Dr. Oz.
Congratulations, Christy and Al. I do have the answers here, but I know you want to talk a little bit about pregnancy first, so take it away.
Okay, we want you to reveal some myths. I think that that would be interesting because we've been talking about that in our download segment all morning long. So, should we start with the first one?
Yeah. So, what are some pregnancy myths? We've been hearing some people say the way you carry, high or low, that maybe means it's a boy or a girl. What are your thoughts on that, doctor?
Well, you know, it's something that I was told also. We've got four kids, and I was under the belief that there might be some validity to it, but there isn't any. It turns out that the way the baby is carried is much more a function of how strong the core belly muscles are in a mom. And, of course, if you've had several babies, then the muscles get a little weaker, so the belly descends a little earlier, and the mom carries it low. People think that's a boy. It's not true. So, unfortunately, that's just purely a myth. So, take another shot at it. Any other myths?
Okay. Well, there goes that. Okay, how about heart rate during the ultrasound? Because with Kendall, I think it was like right around 160, and this time it's right around like 147.
You know, the interesting thing about the heart rate is that it is true that late in the pregnancy, like right before delivery, female children have a little higher heart rate than male children. However, it's so late in the pregnancy, by then you almost always know because you've had an ultrasound or, you know, other clues may have presented themselves. Early in the pregnancy, the first trimester especially, there's no difference at all. Probably no difference for the second trimester either. So I think it's valuable at the very end, but it's too late to be of much meaning.
Doctor, what about morning sickness as it relates to having a girl or a boy?
Now here, there's actually some interesting clues because you know why morning sickness happens? The baby's making this hormone called HCG, and the hormone is normally there, supposed to be there. Little girls make more than little boys. So moms have more morning sickness with female children than male children. And I'm just going to point out something. Morning sickness really isn't only about the morning. And, you know, it can last all day long, as you know. And there's some good things about morning sickness. Turns out people with women with morning sickness seem to have a little fewer miscarriages, some lesser developmental problems with the kid. It's a very small difference, so don't go out and try to get morning sickness, but there's a silver lining around it. But that might be a clue. So have you been having more morning sickness, Christy, or less?
My first trimester, it was more morning sickness. It wasn't throwing up. It was just nauseous all the time and headaches. But now I feel 100%, and I'm 18 weeks.
All right, but, you know, there's just a much better way of doing it, and you had that test done. So if you really want to know, we could avoid all the wives' tales and just find out, because I have the answer right here.
So we're going to reveal ours first and what we thought yesterday from all my stories I've been telling them for the last few weeks. So I said a boy only because of my symptoms being different from when I had Kindle.
Yeah.
I said boy because I know it's a boy.
How do you know? And I said a boy.
Yeah,
we all said that. And it's funny because so many viewers yesterday when we posted this on like my Instagram, a lot of the folks are saying, the viewers are saying boy.
Right.
But we don't really know for sure.
We have no idea.
No clue.
But Dr. Oz does. So Dr. Oz, take it away.
Do I get a drum roll or anything?
Yes.
Yeah, you do.
Envelope here. And the winner is, are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready.
All of us, it's a little boy.
Oh, that's awesome. Wow.
Yay, Kendall, you're having a little brother.
Yeah, a little brother. All those extra push-ups paid off.
That is awesome. Well, wait, and it's so exciting. Your parents are here because they have all granddaughters, right?
Yes, all granddaughters. And even on my husband's side, there's my mom and dad. They came in from Cincinnati.
How nice.
They're the biggest supporters. They are so awesome.
So we're talking either a basketball player or a football player, no doubt about it, huh?
Yeah, no doubt about
it. One of the two.
Yeah.
Or an Indians player.
Or baseball.
Right. Yeah. Or baseball.
Yeah. So
they
got
a guaranteed contract, so we're leaning in that direction.
Yeah. Did Dr. Oz leave? I wanted to thank him. That was the coolest thing ever.
That's really neat. Right?
Now how do you guys feel? I know you've been thinking about it. I know you wanted a boy, Hal. Well, I mean, to be honest with you, come on.
Yeah. But,
I put lipstick on.
Don't wipe it off.
Oh,
that's evidence.
Oh, there you are. Yeah. Dr. Oz, thank you so much. What an honor. Seriously. And your producer was super nice with our producer. We couldn't have asked for this. This is crazy.
Well, you know,
crazy
cool. Yeah. I've got boys and girls. They're both a blessing, as you know, but I'm going to love the fact that the little boy is going to play with her toys. It's going to be a blast.
Yeah.
That's right.
Everything's pink. We need to work on that.
And I love your show. The Dr. Oz show is great. I love it.
I know.
Yeah, you always learn something.
And it's even better now.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we like him even
more. We watch it every episode.
We love you, Dr. Oz. Thank you.
Bye.
Love you guys.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
And he has beautiful grandchildren and children,
Daphne, Oz.
I know you guys are just overjoyed.
We're so excited.
And you'd be excited, we know, whatever it is, because it's just such a thrill having a child. And
but it's good to have that pair. You got the girl, you got the boy, so there you go.
She'll teach him a few things, I think. Kindle can hold her own.
Yes, she can.
As we all know.
Yes.
I'm sure she's going
to. She's been being groomed to have a brother since she was born.
Good stuff. Kendall's just chilling. She's like, whatever.
Well, she's not crying, so we've we've moved.
But she's going to be so happy.
Taking another step. Oh, I know.
So you got a built-in babysitter.
So now you guys have to think of names.
We do.
Fred.
All right.
That's
a start. That's
Fred.
Good.
That's a good
name. That's a good name.
Yeah.
Frank.
Maybe John. I'm getting a lot coming from the studio. John.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Hal Jr.
Oh, no. We want him to actually get to lunch with his lunch money.
We could let Kendall name her baby brother.
We could. Are you excited?
She'll name it after
Thank you guys
I'm
for
happy
coming
for you guys.
In.
Thank you, guys.
We're so thrilled for you guys.
Margaret and Darren, thank you so much for all this, too. You guys were super sweet. This
all right.
Really cool.
Oh, we were all right.
We were all right.
Yes.
Way to go.
You guys bet. That's
not the first, right?
Wow, that's good stuff.
All right, thanks, guys. Man. All right, well, coming up on Fox 8 News in the Morning, it's a Super Baby Tuesday.